Okay, this is Lakshman Vangara from India. So I'm going to present classroom-based action research conducted by me recently in my school. Actually, I work for a government-run school in India. So first, I would like to start my presentation with one wonderful quotation which was inspired me a lot. That is, teaching is a creative activity. You need to find things that work for your children, not just take stuff off the peg. So this is said by Graham Smith. And teacher research as an agency for classroom and school change. So for this classroom-based research, I have chosen topic that strategies to improve the legible handwriting skill of ESL pupils at high school level. So I'm going to present this presentation in this layout. This is the background for this choosing this topic. So this is actually, if you can see the background of this slide, then you can easily understand this is the handwriting of my class 8 school children. So just they are unable to read their own handwriting too. So this made me to think how I can make their handwriting skill good. So, and this kind of handwriting, 85% children have the same handwriting. And in India, most of the children's academic progress is measured in written examinations. So there I thought that I should improve their handwriting skill. So these are some evidences of my school children handwriting. So, and here I strongly believe and agree with Mahatma Gandhi's quotation. I saw that bad handwriting should be regarded as a sign of an imperfect education. So I also, being a language teacher, I got some belief that a student should write legibly. So then I start exploring the possible ways to improve my children's handwriting. Then I devised two things. First of all, I have gone through the literature review and I collected the perceptions of my teachers and the pupils of class 8 about the need of legible handwriting. So the existing studies say that legible handwriting lowers the self-esteem. It is an important skill to be developed at school age. Students should be given ample practice to develop legible handwriting. So then I made my major research questions. What are the strategies to improve the legible handwriting skill of ESL pupils at high school level? So to guide my research, I formulated the three minor research questions. What are the perceptions of the teachers of English and what are the perceptions of the pupils? Then what strategies can help to improve pupils' handwriting skill? Then to know the perception of my colleagues and my fellow teachers, I devised some Google form and I shared across 20 teachers. Out of 20, 18 responded, and I conducted two semi-structured interviews of my three school children. So I analyzed their opinions. Actually, I collected the qualitative data. So most of the teachers said about the causes and consequences of illegible handwriting, and they iterated the need of legible handwriting, and they gave some suggestions to improve the children's handwriting. So, but my students' reflections are very attractive. They said that the reasons for their bad or illegible handwriting is due to a lack of exposure to legible handwriting, and lack of proper guidance and feedback, lack of practice in a proper way, and lack of intimacy with the teachers, and fear towards English subject too. So then I started plan of action and I implemented it. This is the plan of action I devised. So when I interviewed the students and teachers, they said that they gave more focus on four areas. One is lack of knowledge and exposure, and lack of practice, and providing feedback, and exhibiting their handwriting. So for each and every area, I devised some techniques. So to provide knowledge and rich exposure, just I would like to discuss the main four components of handwriting, that is size, shape, and slant, and showing videos of legible handwriting practice, and draw four lines on the blackboard. And in later stages, I started drawing single line, and I started writing on the blackboard. Then Right. So I think you could read. This is the technique I used. These are the classroom evidences I maintained, and I encouraged my fellow teachers to give feedback about the teachers. And this is the so these are the evidences for their improvement. Even I encouraged the peer learning also, a peer assessment. This is the children performance in non-languages subjects too, and students' reflections. They said that their handwriting was improved to a great extent. They became confident, and their reading ability was also improved, and their teacher became their friend. So they gave so many reflections about this program and about the improvement of their handwriting. And my colleagues also gave positive reflections towards this program, and they said that they would conduct, they inspired with this program, and they said that they would conduct such programs in the school. So these are the major findings. Students are able to write legibly, and they are able to understand the importance of legible handwriting, and they could track their own progress too. So this is next, students are showing interest to try different forms of English. And there was a healthy competition in the classroom. Students are scoring good marks in the exams, not only in English, but also in non-languages. And students are using more adjectives in their conversation too. And my colleagues started writing legibly on the blackboard.
Wonderful. So this is all my journey. Thank you. I'm sorry, Laxman.
It's okay.
Oh, you're nearly there. Okay, go and finish your sentence.
All right. Thank you all.
Oh, there was the thank you. Wonderful. Can we give Laxman a round of applause, everyone? What do you think?
Okay, thank you.
I want to get a really good applause on the recording. Eventually. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, one and all.